All the time I've come to Brick House, this is the quietest it's been. It's only for a little bit, because very soon there'll be like a tsunami of people coming in here.
It's nice.
You're chilling right. Normally you're on lunch right now, right? It's a little break.
Yeah.
You're working with Zurdo, you're working with Regis, you're working with Scrappy. What's the update on all your fighters?
Regis is most likely going to fight Devin Haney. I'm not sure what the holdup is.
We're waiting for Haney to sign. Maybe if you have a pen, you could lend it to him.
No, he's... Come on, man. Devin Haney isn't scared.
I didn't say he's scared. I just said he can't find his pen.
No, he's a great... He'll sign it. He's a great champion, and I'm looking forward to that one.
That's a big one.
Yeah.
A lot of people are picking Haney to win everywhere I go.
I know.
Which is okay.
That's okay. You know, who cares? The only person that needs to really believe is Regis, and he does.
He can't wait.
There's no such thing as doubt in his head, you know, and his team. I don't doubt him either. I don't doubt Regis either. I don't doubt any of my guys.
I picked them to win, so let's see.
So then, Zurdo is going to fight...
Cruiserweight.
Cruiserweight. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say who he's going to fight.
But he has something coming up.
He's got something coming up.
A big name.
Same with Scrappy and... And Kareem is hopefully on the same card in October.
Amazing.
Yeah.
That'd be sick. And then boxing, there's Oscar Valdez and Navarrete. It's a very, very interesting fight. Two come forward fighters and let their hands go. What do you think?
Oscar Valdez and Navarrete? Yeah, that's a fun fight. That's a fun fight.
As long as it's going to last.
Yeah.
Because they're going to let bombs away.
Yeah, I favor Oscar Valdez in that.
Logan and Dylan Danis, what do you think, if it happens?
I've never seen, honestly, I haven't seen enough of Dylan Danis.
I don't think he can fight. He's good at marketing himself.
I hope Logan wins.
He will.
I know Logan. I know Jay, really? Too. I know them. I like them.
So. By the way, do you know Ryan Garcia? Do you know him?
Yeah, I know Ryan.
Today's his birthday, 26.
Oh, really? Happy birthday,
Happy birthday, Ryan. Tell me about the first time you met Ryan. How old was he? Where were you?
Oh, man, we were amateurs. We were in an amateur tournament in Oxnard in...
8 years ago, seven
no,
years ago?
No, longer than that. 2011, maybe.
Wow, 12 years ago.
Like yeah.
He was, what, 14?
Yeah. And he's always...
stood out.
Yeah. He was so fast and stuff. He's a good kid. He's a good guy. Yeah.
30 million is
Happy
last
birthday,
fight.
Man.
Hey, 30 million. Next one, 60.
Hopefully. I hope he makes enough money to never have to do anything again.
When you see someone like Ryan in amateurs, do you know, wow, this kid will be a superstar?
Yeah.
Who else did you see back then that you knew? Like, Crawford was big in amateurs.
Yeah, but it's crazy because sometimes they don't end up, you know, like I remember watching Frankie Gomez, you know, life sometimes gets in the way and stuff. And
correct.
You,
not everybody
you think
makes
these
it.
Guys will, and then sometimes guys who you didn't think, I don't think anyone in the amateurs that like a lot of people that like Crawford said doubted him and stuff when he was an amateur.
No, in amateurs, he was always a standout. I think they doubted him. Like me, I doubted him in the pros. In amateurs, I knew he was like the man.
Right, but he didn't go to the Olympics.
But he was really good. Everyone knew that.
Yeah, for
Tank
sure.
was really good. You know, in the amateurs, when Tank would fight, there would be 400 or 500 people there. And you know, you may move from ring to ring. The people moved with him as he moved.
That shows you when someone has star power, even at a young age.
Yeah, and that's why he sells out now. He knows to be a showman. He used to do the Jimmy Snuka backflips on the thing and acrobatics and all that.
Yeah.
So he's a showman.
Yeah.
They're not a big talker, but his boxing does the talking.
Yeah.
What does Tank do next, in your opinion?
You know, that's the weird thing. A lot of people aren't talking about what who he's going to fight next or who he should fight next. But, like, I hope it's somebody good, you know, because I hope it's somebody that he wants to fight. I know he has a list of guys he wants to fight, and I hope it's somebody that he wants to fight. Because, like I'm not a fan of guys overstaying in boxing. I hope Tank makes his money and gets out, you know. I hope he... Yeah,
Andre Ward, 28 fights. That's it.
I hope Crawford.
Sugar Ray Leonard, only 44 fights.
Said too. I hope he just got the big payday that he deserves.
Probably 30 million or something.
Yeah, and but I think yeah, I hope he doesn't stay too much longer either. I hope Canelo leaves soon. Like, you know, like nobody wants to see these guys pass their time get hurt. You know,
we see a lot of that. Unfortunately, I meet a lot of former fighters. You know, with the speech, with the physical, they can't see. There's a lot of medical. Fans love you when you're active. The day you retire, nobody cares.
Yeah.
No, they try. They come to fight. It's sad.
Yeah.
So people sacrifice their health. That's why you should respect all fighters and be nice to all fighters.
Exactly.
So Julian, tell people where to follow you.
At Julian_Chua.
Chua. Make sure to follow him. Stay tuned. Right here, one of the best gyms in the world, Brick House Boxing. A lot of champions coming. Stay tuned. Nelly Stuckback reporting.